I'm Eliana from the Boys and Girls Club of Greater Anaheim Cypress, and I'm here to give my advice for back to school for 7th graders. So first up is all I wanted you to know, 7th graders, is to chill. Honestly, you guys need to chill because sure, middle school can be kind of scary, but it's only the beginning. Take a few deep breaths before class, drink some water, take a break, hang out with your friends, drink lunch, talk, be wild, and be free. My second piece of advice is studying and grades. Make sure you study. Although I go to a private school, in any school, it is good to study. High schools look at your grades, and I'm pretty sure colleges look at your grades too from middle school. So make sure you keep your grades decent with A's and B's or C's. Try your best not to fail class. Number three, relationships. It's okay to think to have a little crush here and there, but or even a humongous one, that's fine, I guess. But I recommend to probably keep like dating until high school or even college. Why? Because middle school relationships don't last super long. And also, please don't date high schoolers, that'll be weird. Your social life. Number four. Go out with your friends, your social life and hobbies. Go out with your friends, have a life, go to the movies with Vanessa or shop with Natalie. Go have a life. I also recommend finding a hobby like sports or art or music or dance. It can help you in the long run, and plus they can be very fun. My last piece of advice is your mental health. Your mental health. So lastly, your mental health is very important because this comes before your grades and your hobbies and everything else. Always remember to stay happy and avoid toxic things in your life. Make sure to always keep in touch of how you're feeling and always talk to a trusted friend, your parents, or a trusted adult. Also remember to vent out your feelings if you need to like one of those, or don't bottle up your feelings. Like, you can like write a story on how you're feeling, or like write in your diary or journal. And yeah, so thank you for watching, and I hope that all of you have a good day, and that you 7th graders have a good middle school experience. Bye!
Hi, this is Ava, and I'm going to give you some middle school advice.
Alright, let's do this. So first things first, you should focus on your classes, because, you know, grades and stuff. My next tip is everyone feels nervous too, and it's okay. Third, you should use your agenda to, like, you know, organize your stuff. This next tip is only if we go back to school, like, in person. I recommend getting an oversized t-shirt for PE because changing can feel uncomfortable, especially like when you're like starting out. And yeah, getting an oversized t-shirt for PE, do that, yeah.
Hi guys, my name is Justin Sawyer, and I'm a member of the Boys and Girls Club. I am currently a sophomore, and I will be giving advice to freshmen. So I recommend that you be prepared. You join as many club activities as possible. Go to football games, go to homecoming, go to all the dances. The reason why I'm saying to be prepared is because you will have a lot of classes. Therefore, you will see a lot of teachers. And therefore, you just have to be prepared and have your book ready, because sometimes the teacher gets mad if you don't have your book prepared. And making your life more organized is just easier for you. Also, the reason why I said to join clubs is because you will feel more involved in school spirit, and you will like school better because it's more easier to cope with. Also, go to homecoming dances because you can make new friends and create new memories that will last a lifetime. And so, yeah, like, and also, yeah, so freshman year was a bit confusing for me because I wasn't really organized and I didn't have my book ready, therefore I had to like miss class or miss info. And then it was hard for me to catch up with all the assignments. But I recommend that you just check in with your teacher and make sure that everything is good. Bye!
Hi, my name's Caitlin and I'm a junior this year. So you just started sophomore year. Let me tell you, my sophomore year wasn't fun at all. But the one thing that did make it fun were my friends and, surprisingly, the schoolwork. In sophomore year, you're expected to do a lot of things such as not procrastinate, always keep on time, have good management on everything, and devote yourself to a group project. Now, my advice for this is, I agree with all of them. You should not procrastinate. So in sophomore year, it's kind of a training ground for your junior year. I'm a junior right now, and let me just say, thank God I did so well in my sophomore year. All I ever did was go on my planner, always checked my teachers when things were due. I had to know when things were due. I always checked my email. I never procrastinated on certain projects. Some projects had a later due date, so I pushed those to the side for a little bit. I bet you're wondering, what about my relationships with my friends and other friends and special friends? I say focus on your schoolwork, and even if you do get a significant other, please, please, school comes first. Don't worry, they can wait, and they have school as well. It's best to not distract each other, but not to forget that you guys are best friends, so it's all cool. Friends, on the other hand, you will lose friends no matter what. You gain new ones. They don't replace them, but they do give you a new sense of a circle. You have a new circle in your life. I know for sure, when I went into sophomore year, I had the best friends, and that I'm still friends with this year. I did drift with some other people. However, I still keep in touch. And even if I don't keep in touch, I know that they're there for me whenever I can see them. Study notes, you already know. But for tests, this is very important. Most of your tests create most of your grade. Homework can't save you this year. In freshman year, it was kind of a training ground for sophomore year. Now sophomore year is a training ground for junior year. So what I like to propose is that you focus on studying a whole bunch before a test and make sure that you cover every topic that is on the test. Ask your teachers. And my favorite thing to say is, don't assume that this won't be on the exam. Study everything you can and try to think of some things that may or may not be on the exam. You never know. Could be, when was this person's birthday? You have to know. You never know. It could be on the test and no one can know. Pop quizzes don't really happen, but if they do happen at your school, please be ready. That means you have to study, at least freshen up your mind every day. How I like to do that is I repeat every lesson, try to think of everything that I did that day, try to think what was the lesson, see if I was really paying attention. When planning for college right at this time, some people like to take it above the notch of how much money I can save, what college should I go to, what I don't even know what degree I want to do. Don't panic, don't you worry, you have enough time. When junior year rolls around, you still have enough time. The only thing that you have to worry about is, what are you going to college after school, or are you going to work, or maybe you're going to the military. You never know your choices, things change, your course can change. It's okay. Like I said before, it's okay to take your time. Don't worry, no one is falling behind. Your grades are important, yes, but most colleges, what they don't tell you is that based off your college entry exam, they base it off that, which is the SAT or the ACT, or if you're going to a community college, they're basing off how well you are doing in the community college. So that is your entry exam right there. Finally, my final favorite advice. Take your time. Take your time. You are not in a race. Everyone goes at their own pace, okay? Now, I'm no counselor, but I would just like to say, good luck. It's hard. It's a challenge, but you can overcome it. And you know what? Sophomore year, that was my favorite year.